Aditya L1, the first solar observatory from India. In Sanskrit, Aditya means sun and it's orbiting the Earth's L1 point. So, Aditya L1. After the groundbreaking success of Chandrayaan 3 mission, ISRO launched their first solar mission named Aditya L1. Sun, the king of our solar system, is the brightest object in our sky. It's a G-type yellow dwarf star, in short, a very rare kind of star in our whole universe. It occupies 99.86% mass of our whole solar system. This means everything other than Sun in our solar system occupies only 0.14% mass. This massive fireball is very easy to observe from Earth. However, I don't recommend you to see the Sun without any sun shield. Despite being the brightest object, the Sun is the object we least know about in our whole solar system. Just for example, we know the Sun's surface is way cooler than Sun's atmosphere, means the corona, but we don't know the cause behind it. To try to answer those peculiar questions, ISRO has packed some industry-leading equipments with Aditya L1. Today, we will discuss about that. Besides that, we will know why observing the sun is so important and why observing the sun from space is even more important. We will also know how and why a spacecraft is orbiting a hypothetical point in space, which means orbiting nothing. This video is all about Aditya L1. Hello everyone, my name is Aditya and welcome back to my YouTube channel SkyMap. Sun, the godfather, the ultimate powerhouse of our whole solar system, is originally a plasma ball. Directly or indirectly, it's the source of each and every energy on Earth. In fact, the energy you are using to see this video on YouTube has come from the Sun. But the main concern is, we have never seen the darkest phase of this plasma ball. A strong solar wind can wipe up life on Earth. On 4th February 2022, a small geomagnetic storm destroyed 38 Starlink satellites. In fact, in the year 1859, the biggest solar storm hit Earth. This great event is famous as the Carrington Event. It lasted more than one day, from 1st September to 2nd September. The power of the solar wind was so strong that auroras was visible from far south as Caribbean and Mexico, which we generally see in the poles of our planet. The storm destroyed the telegram system of that time. If the same kind of storm hits Earth today, it can easily destroy the internet, electric supply, satellite, space station, and many more, which can easily set back human civilization for at least 200 years. Yet, scientists think this is not anywhere near the darkest phase of the Sun. Moreover, studying a star can answer many fundamental questions, like how life evolved on Earth, how do stars generate energy, how our star is different from the other stars, and many more. So, studying the Sun is very important for human being. To understand better, I highly recommend you to see this video after watching this one. Earth has a protective atmosphere that saves us from the Sun's harmful ultraviolet radiation. But if I want to study an object without touching it, then every light spectrum coming out from it is important. Maybe it can be ultraviolet or visible light. When something gets heated up or burns up, it radiates a huge amount of energy in ultraviolet and infrared spectrum. So, studying the same spectrum can be very helpful for studying the object. But as I said before, a lot of light gets blocked by the atmosphere of the Earth. Most importantly, the ozone layer. So, if we want to study the sun in detail, then we have to observe it from the space. In fact, NASA designed the famous Parker probe in a way that it will orbit the sun within its corona, where it will experience more than 1300 degrees Celsius temperature. It's the fastest man-made object till date. Let's come back to the Aditya L1. It will observe the sun while orbiting the Earth's L1 point. Now, what is the L1 point and why Aditya L1 is orbiting it? L stands for Lagrange point. Every planet in our solar system has 5 Lagrange points: L1, L2, L3, L4, and L5. These 5 points are the places where the gravitational force from the star and the planet cancels out each other. So, any object placed at these 5 points will neither experience any force from the sun nor from the planet. Technically, if we place an object at these 5 hypothetical points, then it will orbit the sun with the planet as the point moves. So ISRO placed Aditya L1 in L1 point, which is about 1.5 million kilometers away from the Earth. Not only ISRO, NASA and ESA's joint mission, Solar and Heliospheric Observatory, SOHO, is also placed in Earth's L1 point. NASA's James Webb Space Telescope and ESA's Gaia Telescope placed in Earth's L2 Lagrange point to see the outer space. But every spacecraft placed in this Lagrange point orbits its respective point, when theoretically they can stay there without any movement and fuel burn. Let's jump to the practical world. Earth's Lagrange point is theoretically a point where anything can stay as it is, without experiencing any force from the sun and the Earth. But it will experience each and every force induced by other planets and other solar bodies. Earth's Lagrange point is special for Earth-Sun system, but not special for Sun and other planets' combined system. For example, Aditya L1 will experience attraction from the gas giants like Jupiter. Scientists found that orbiting the Lagrange point is the easiest way to reduce these forces while burning a very little amount of fuel. For the same reason, due to some calculation error, we lost the SOHO spacecraft in the year 1998, though scientists were able to find it within just 3 months. So, ISRO decided to place their first solar observatory in the L1 point while orbiting it, which ISRO is calling the halo orbit of Aditya L1. The Aditya L1 spacecraft was launched on 2nd September 2023, 11:50 Indian Standard Time, from the Satish Dhawan Space Center, Sriharikota, with the help of a PSLV XL rocket. It was the 57th successful launch of the famous PSLV family. After 126 days of long journey, it reached the L1 point on 6th January 2024. At around 4 p.m. Indian Standard Time. Now, it's orbiting the L1 point. It has many industry-leading equipments or payloads attached to it. Just for example, the Solar Ultraviolet Imaging Telescope, SUTE. It is mainly made to capture the full disk image of the sun in near ultraviolet wavelength. Full disk means it can capture the whole sun at once. It can capture images in these 11 different ultraviolet wavelengths, where we have never seen the sun in these 9 wavelengths. These are the first image of the sun in these 9 wavelengths. The outermost surface of the sun is called photosphere. In this image, you can see the photosphere. Normally during sunrise and sunset, we see the photosphere of the sun. And the halo effect around the sun is the sun's atmosphere, the solar corona. The layer in between photosphere and solar corona is called chromosphere. It's an almost transparent layer and can be 1500 to 3000 km thick. This chromosphere is only visible in specific ultraviolet wavelength or during solar eclipse. This instrument SUTE has taken many images of the chromosphere and the photosphere. It has also captured the sunspot and filaments. Sunspots are the place on the sun's surface where the temperature is relatively low, means 1000 to 1500 degrees Celsius lower than normal surface. Yet, the temperature of sunspots can reach over 3500 degrees Celsius. These structures are not small. Its diameter can be several times of Earth. Due to this low temperature, it appears as a black spot on the sun. Another and my personal favorite instrument is the visible line emission coronagraph. To understand it better, we have to know what is coronagraph. If we need to see any dim object behind a bright object, then we have to block the bright light source of the bright object. On the other hand, if we want to study the solar atmosphere, corona, then we have to capture it. Being a dim object, we have to block the light of the sun. Then only the corona will be visible to us. During solar eclipse, it's easily visible. Nowadays, we artificially block the sunlight and see the corona. That's called coronagraph. Before Aditya L1, ESA's SOHO spacecraft was also able to do the same with great accuracy. SOHO spacecraft has 3 coronagraphs, C1, C2, and C3. With the help of C1 coronagraph, SOHO spacecraft was able to block 1.1 solar radius area to see the solar corona. As C1 is not working right now, with the help of C2, it can now block 2 solar radius area to see the solar corona. So, while blocking the sun, a lot of area of corona gets also blocked. But with the help of VELC, Aditya L1 will block only 1.05 solar radius area to see the sun's atmosphere. As the area of the blocking is only 5% higher than the sun's radius, it will capture a great amount of detail of the sun's atmosphere. It can also solve the temperature mystery of solar corona. The magnetometer attached to Aditya L1 will detect the effect of magnetic field of other planets and solar bodies on Earth's L1 point. It will also study the effect of solar wind on magnetic field. On 25th January 2024, Aditya L1 has successfully deployed the magnetic boom while orbiting the L1 point. Another 2 payloads attached to Aditya L1 are Solar Wind Particle Experiment, ASPEX, and Plasma Analyzer Package of Aditya, PAPA. This will detect the solar wind and its composition. The first one, ASPEX, has 2 parts. Low energy particle detector named Solar Wind Ion Spectrometer, SWIS, and high energy particle detector named Suprathermal Electronic Particle Spectrometer. SWIS will measure the ions in the energy range of 100 electron volt to 20 kilo electron volt, and steps will measure the high energy particles in the energy range of 20 kilo electron volt to 20 mega electron volt. Another payload, PAPA, is made to study the temperature, energy distribution, and velocity of the solar wind. It also has two parts, the solar wind electron energy probe, SWIP, and solar wind ion composition analyzer, SWICER. Where SWIP will detect the electrons only, SWICER will detect the electrons and ions, both particles. This will help us to predict the solar wind as well as understand the composition of the solar wind. We have already received data from SWIS and STEPS. There are two more payloads in Aditya L1. Solar Low Energy X-ray Spectrometer, SoLEXS, and High Energy L1 Orbiting X-ray Spectrometer, HILAS. These two instruments are designed to study the solar flares in X-ray spectrum. Combining these two instruments, Aditya L1 can measure the solar flares in X-ray flask ranging from 1 kilo electron volt to 150 kilo electron volt. It will divide the sun into many small parts and measure the solar flares. In future, this data can help scientists to predict solar flares and coronal mass ejection, which is directly related to the solar wind. Helios has already sent data about the solar flares. Apart from all these, 7 payloads in Aditya L1 are all homegrown. Means all payloads are made in India and by Indian scientists. Let's take a closer look at the payloads and where it is made. All these small steps have helped ISRO to reduce the cost of the whole mission by a significant amount. Chandrayaan 3 was already a very cost-effective mission, where the cost was almost $75 million. But the cost of the Aditya L1 was almost the half of the Chandrayaan 3, almost $45 million. In today's competitive world, ISRO is unbeatable if we talk about cost-effective missions. This was a brief introduction about Aditya L1. If you want to know about the sun in detail, like how does it generates energy, how it's burning, what's inside its core, etc., etc., please write down in the comment section. I'll make a separate video on this topic. If you found this cosmic journey as fascinating as I did, please give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends and family members. And remember, keep looking up, stay curious, and explore the mysteries of the night sky.